Praise the Lord, saints.
Praise the Lord.
Let's say it like we mean it this morning. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
We all know when praises go up, blessings come down.
Sure. Amen.
If you want a blessing this morning, always remember, praises go up, blessings come down. As I was sitting here this morning, I heard his testimony. And you know, I'm glad to know that God is an on-time God.
Yes, he is.
I said God is an on-time God.
Yes, he is.
And I thank him so much.
Good.
You know, it's good to see y'all this morning.
Good to be here.
I thank God for allowing each and every last one of us to get up this morning.
Amen.
You know, when I woke up this morning, even last night, before I went to bed, my mind was on Jesus.
Hallelujah.
When I woke up this morning, my mind was on Jesus.
Amen.
And you know, when you think about the goodness of God and how he kept us through our storms, through our trials and tribulations, anything the Lord will have us to do, our soul said yes, Lord.
Amen.
Yes to your will, yes to your way.
Amen.
Have your way, Holy Spirit, on this service today.
Amen.
For we know one thing, Lord, without you, we can't do anything.
Amen.
We need you. Holy Spirit, we welcome you on today. I often think of myself. You know, like I said, I heard the testimony of the young lady, you know, about she going through her trials and tribulation. I think about myself once upon a time when I was going through them trials and tribulation, and how I was struggling with myself, not knowing God's way, God's will. But I thank God for being who he are and what he is. He's the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And anything you need of is in the cross. Everything you need of is in the cross. Your house is in the cross. Your car is in the cross. Your healing is in the cross.
Yes, it is.
Your sickness in your body, you need healing, is in the cross.
Yes, it is.
Jesus has already paid for whatever that we need on this side. And he already have taken care of what we need on the other side. Somebody get God. You know, once upon a time, a long ago, when I get into a trial of tribulation, and the doors of church always have been open, and I would not come in the presence of the Lord, thinking that would help deal with what issue that I had going on. But I find out in studying the Word of God that we run to God. Not from God. Whatever you're going through, whatever situation you may be having, you run to God. Because that's where your help comes from. And a lot of, being taught to stay at home, or you go missing, or you're laying in bed, you're sleeping, your head hurting, and not eating, not want to eat. All those things that Satan has to produce to us, to get us out the will of God. But anytime, anything going on in your life, you run to God. He has the answer for whatever we're searching for. Whatever that void in your life. God is the way, the truth, and the life. And I want to share with you on today Psalms 119:105. It says in his word, your word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. The only lamp in the world that is true. The only lamp in the world that is true. God is the way, the truth, and the life. We must understand as a child of God, as a believer, we must seek the Lord while he may be found and call upon him while he is near. The Word of God is the only true light. He is the only true lamb in the world. Everything that you want to know about the Bible is found in. You want to know about the Word of God is found in the Bible. Matthew 4:4 tells us, Jesus said, a man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. So is the need for natural food is necessary for your physical well-being. Likewise, To study and understand the Word of God is necessary for your spiritual well-being. You must feed your spiritual man with the Word of God if you want to grow. You must understand your soul is at stake. It is the most single important thing in your life. You will live forever, but where will your address be? In John 5:39 tells us, for you search the scripture, for in them you think you have eternal life, and they which will testify of me. All life is in Christ. To have that life, you must accept what Jesus has done for us at the cross, laying down his life, paying his sin, that past, present, and future for those who believe as a believer. John 14:6 tells Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, and no man can come to the Father but by him. The cross changed everything for us, y'all. Due to what Christ did at that cross, we have the benefit of his power, which is unlimited, because he is God all by himself.
Yes, it is.
He don't need no help. We as a believer should continue to exercise faith in Christ Jesus. Whatever you need is in the cross.
Amen.
Again, church.
Amen.
We have not because we ask not. And I thank the Lord so much for being in our life. Let him lead and guide you. Whatever door has been closed, he'll open up.
Amen.
Whatever door has been opened, he'll close it. So I thank God again for his son, for the cleansing of his blood, cleansing up of all unrighteousness. And church, don't walk off and leave God. You know, things happen in our life, we sometimes say God had left us. Doesn't happen. He said he'll never leave you nor forsake you. We must believe that. Stand on his word. When trial and tribulation come in your life, stand.
Amen.
Stand on the word of God. It will help you throughout your trials and tribulations. God loves you so much, and so do I. May God bless all of you all. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen.